Welcome back to another video. My name is Crystal, a second year mechanical engineering student. I'm sure many of you guys have this question in the back of your mind: what I can do with an engineering degree after graduation? So in today's video, I'm gonna show you guys some traditional and non-traditional pathways that you can do with an engineering degree. Graduating with an engineering degree, the most common career choice is to work in industry as a graduate engineer. In Canada, fresh out of college, you can register to become an engineer in training, which is often referred to an EIT. After working in the industry for a few years, you can then register to become a PEng, which is professional engineer. Engineering is a very, very broad discipline. Usually in undergraduate programs, they only offer traditional degrees such as mechanical, civil, electrical, mining, and so on. However, your degree doesn't limit what you can do in the future. Usually within each discipline, you can choose to specialize in very specific areas. For example, in mechanical engineering, you can choose to specialize in mechatronics, robotics, biomedical, thermal fluids, manufacturing, and so on. Another traditional pathway for many engineering students is to go into graduate school to become a research scientist. For people who are really interested in like a very specific areas within the disciplines, for example, for someone really interested in machine learning, robotics, or composite materials, you can choose to go into graduate school to further expand your knowledge. Being in academia really allows you to work with cutting-edge technology at the front end, and it allows you to really use your creativity to develop new products. Other than pursuing traditional careers after graduation, many engineering students decided to take on some very different career paths outside of engineering. So some of the more common alternative paths to engineering are business management, finance, consulting, entrepreneurship, maybe medicine, and even law school. Business is probably the number one alternative for engineering students. Engineers usually work with a lot of numbers, and they have trained to become fairly decent at analyzing and solving problems. So when it comes to jobs in finance, they can usually handle it fairly well. For example, in consulting, you'll usually have to work with a big data set and really try to extract the core problems. After that, you have to strategize and come up with an alternative solution. Also in careers such as investment banking and venture capital, being really comfortable with numbers and having an analytical mindset would definitely be really beneficial. Another great alternative is to start your own business and become an entrepreneur. This really allows you to follow your passion. Many founders of big successful tech companies as well as their CEOs have engineering degrees. And in UBC, there's the option of minor in commerce and entrepreneurship, and they help you to become successful business leaders. And also in the engineering physics program, as well as the integrated engineering program, they have courses that help you to start your own business. Other career choices are even going into medical school or going to law school. Engineering degree gives you a very solid foundation. So if you are someone that interested in technology as well as the health sciences, definitely consider going to med school because you can really help people and make an impact on the world. Also, going to law school is a great choice if you're interested in the legal business as well as in public service. Many engineering grads actually go to law school to become a patent lawyers, which is dealing with the intellectual properties as well as looking at the technical patents. So in conclusion, your engineering education can really help you develop many great transferable skills that you can apply in many disciplines. Some of these great skills include effective time management and strategy planning, as well as good communication and teamwork, analytical and critical thinking mindset, etc., etc. So being engineering students, I would really encourage you to be open-minded and welcome new opportunities. That's the end of the video. I hope you learned something useful. I'll see you next time.